Well, it's Carl Marston here from East Anglian Daily Times. Now, at Western Homes Community Stadium, very familiar surroundings for me. Another big day for the club, with John McGreal being appointed the new manager today. We've got interviews with John and also with the chairman, Robbie Cowley.
John, well, welcome to Colchester United. It must be a terrifically proud day for you.
Oh, massively. It's one of them stages in my career where, you know, I think it's the right time. I think the club over the last, you know, 6 months really, when it first come around, didn't feel as though I was quite ready, and I think now is possibly the right time with the new project that the club are looking to use to move forward.
Yeah, and obviously with Tony Humes as well as director of football, that will help you out as well, knowing familiar faces like that around the building.
Yeah, as I said, we've worked together 6 or 7 years, we've done a lot together from the under 13s right the way through now to the 21s, and now making the step now towards the first team, so hopefully it's a nice gradual progression.
And what are your ambitions for next season, your first year as a senior manager?
Well, hopefully I want to give it a really good go, a good account of ourselves. You know, we need the fans behind us, which we will definitely have. We want to make a statement of intent through the pre-season if we can. And get everyone together. That's the main thing. Get everyone together and we'll pull all in the right direction. And let's have a good go.
Yeah, and recruitment over the summer obviously be crucial for the club, because you probably lose one or two players and they're out of contract.
Yeah, I think that's going to be inevitable. Up and down the country, really. It is that time of season. Players' contracts are going to be up. Yes. Also, recruiting new players coming in. So we will do our due diligence over the next couple of weeks. And, hopefully we get a couple in.
Yeah, and an exciting new era, hopefully, for the club.
Yep, absolutely. That's what you always say. Every time there's something like this, it is a fresh start. So.
And a decision you've made quite quickly, I think, after Kevin's departure, within a week, and obviously no qualms about who the new man was going to be.
No, I think when, before, you know, the last time that we were looking for something, we were looking internally, John would have been our third choice at the time, but the club wasn't really quite the right place for that to happen then.
No.
But with Tony Humes coming back in, we've got a lot of things in place now where that allows it to be the right move.
So it's the right structure in place now.
Yeah, and, absolutely right.
And what would you, how would you describe John's strengths? You say he would have been your number 12.
Oh, I think from what I know of John, he's an excellent coach. He's very good at the coaching. I think when you come and watch the 21s, you know, you see a really disciplined and quite exciting performance. You know, they play good expansive football, which is the way we want to play. But in a way, you know, I can't remember many 21 games where we've leaked a lot of goals.
No.
Or we haven't been able to hold on at the end, you know, or we've conceded last minute goals. They're good disciplined performances, but also quite expansive and good to watch.
Yeah, you touched upon that, and perhaps that's the problem with the first team a little bit this year, was those sort of late goals. And
the late goals have killed us, you know. Yes. I mean, what was it, 14 points or something? We conceded to late goals.
Yes. But now you're, as Colchester United fans, looking forward to hopefully a very bright future.
Yeah, I do think so. I've said it a few times today. Every cloud has to have a silver lining. I think we start next season in a league where we can have expectations of ourselves. You know, more than we have been able to do in the last few years. You know, we have had one of the lower budgets in the league, and it has been tough for us.
Yes.
I think we go into next season with expectations, and then let's get some momentum going in the right direction.
Yeah, that was a terrific centre-half during your playing career. I guess you pride yourselves on your teams not conceding many goals, and hopefully next season you'll be looking to have maybe a tighter defence or a tighter team.
You know, we'd love to, but you know, I'm possession-based manager as such throughout the 21s. You know, we'd like to tighten things up, so you know, there's still a lot of work to do on the training ground on all aspects. There's not just the defence, it's also we need to score more goals. You know, we're going down into division, and you know, to get promotion or to get in and around them promotion areas, you know, you've got to score goals. So that's another area we will be working on.